A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 9th April, on the front page you have Rafael, Modi gave unprecedented waivers in offset agreement. So this is the highlights of the exclusive coverage by the Hindu newspaper on the official papers as such, which have been now come out of the cabinet committee on security, which is headed by the prime minister himself. He had given unprecedented and exceptional waivers to MS Dassault Aviation and MS Meda in the offset contracts they signed with the Indian government on September 23, 2016 as part of the 7.87 billion euro Rafael deal. So these waivers granted at the highest level of political decision making were exemptions given to the two private French companies from having to comply with provisions of standard contract document of defense procurement procedure 2013. So the two key issues on which waivers were given were provisions to be made in the offset clause for arbitration and access to books of accounts of the industrial suppliers. So these two waivers were given. Also within the cabinet committee, late defense minister Manohar Parrikar, he was uncomfortable with such major deviations from defense procurement procedure 2013, and you can see. So the Defence Acquisition Council also dropped the Defence Procurement Procedure provisions on penalties for use of undue influence and agency commission from the offset clause. So these are provisions which are there in the Defence Procurement Procedure to ensure that corruption does not take place. But these provisions on penalties were also dropped. Also, the offset obligation which is there of 30,000 crores. So this offset obligation was also heavily backloaded, means it is spread over a period of 7 years, and there is no need for any discharge in the first 3 years, and 57% is in the last year, the seventh year. So that's what it is called, heavily backloaded. So that is also in favor of the private French companies. And this is Supreme Court refuses to stay release of Modi biopic. So the Modi movie would be released, and Supreme Court has refused to intervene in the release of the film. And this is Supreme Court increases VVPAT verification. So the Supreme Court has increased VVPAT trail verification to 5 random EVMs in each assembly constituency. So this is the order of the Supreme Court now, the case which we have been discussing for so long. And this is Indian Air Force presents proof to show F-16 was shot down. So this was also an issue that in the Feb 27 attack, whether the Pakistani F-16 was shot down or not by Wing Commander Abhinandan Vardhman, who himself was piloting a MiG-21 which came down, and he was arrested. He was taken under custody of the Pakistan authorities, and then he was handed over to India. On page 7 you have Army gets Dhanush artillery guns. So this is the indigenously upgraded version of Bofors guns which were procured in 1980s, which have been given to the Army. So the Ordnance Factory Board handed over the first batch of 6 Dhanush artillery guns to the Army. So these are indigenously upgraded version of Swedish Bofors which were procured in 1980s. You should know about Dhanush, what are Dhanush. So you can see the indigenization level of the gun, it is said, will go up to 91%. Presently it is about 81%. Then below you have IIT Madras tops centers high ranking institutions. So education amongst education ranking, higher education ranking, IIT Madras ranks number 1 overall. You can see second is ISC Bengaluru, IIT Delhi, IIT Bombay and IIT Kharagpur. These are the top 5 overall. Then in universities, the top 5 are given. In engineering, the top 5, medical, management, and amongst overall colleges too. Then below you have Supreme Court may consider plea against order on TikTok. So TikTok is a mobile application, and Madras High Court has asked the center to prohibit download of TikTok. Now the CJI has indicated that the Supreme Court would look into a petition challenging an interim order of the Madras High Court. Also above you have Supreme Court. Why should government officers head temples? So So this is Justice S.A. Bobade who has now wondered aloud why government officials should be in charge of managing temples in a secular country. So these oral observations of the judge came in the backdrop of allegations raised that devotees were subjected to harassment at the hands of staffers at Jagannath temple in Puri. So this is a case which has been going on for some time. There were protests also over here in Jagannath temple in Puri in Odisha. Then on the editorial page, the first editorial is Fighting Together. So this is regarding BSP, SP and RLD coming together in Uttar Pradesh, the Samajwadi Party, Bahujan Samaj Party and Rashtriya Lokdal. So it says that they need to convince voters that they are on the same page. So they have formed an alliance. Then this is Maldivian Wave. So this is regarding the front page news of yesterday. President Soli's political party got a landslide majority in the parliamentary elections. The Majlis elections, parliament of Maldives is called Majlis. So this is regarding that. The lead article, Open Up the Supreme Court. So this is regarding the judiciary, you know, that it, as it is confident of its place in a democratic republic, it must not worry about public scrutiny of judicial appointments. So it had refused to bring in transparency in that aspect. We had seen this case. The Supreme Court ruled in its favor. Then this is Playing Politics Over Golan Heights. So this was also prominently news. Golan Heights, which has been, you know, captured by Israel in the 1967 war, and now US has recognized Israel's sovereignty in Golan Heights, which actually belongs to Syria. So this recognition of US, it is said, is a challenge to the rules-based international order. So this is regarding that. Then on the op-ed page, we have this coverage on crorepatis in parliament. So this is rich people's club, which is governing a largely poor country. Coverage on that. Then this is continuation from the front page. Actually, BJP has released its manifesto. So this is regarding that. And below you have what we discussed on the front page again. IF presence proof to show F-16 was shut down and Supreme Court refusing to release Modi biopic. Then on page 13, you have this coverage on the waivers given in offset agreements in the Rafael deal. On international page, you have Sri Lanka seeks international military training from India. So this is Sri Lanka under Sirisena. It met the Defense Secretary of India. Maithripala Sirisena is the President of Sri Lanka. And it has asked for enhancing bilateral defense cooperation between the two countries. So these aspects were discussed, you can see. It is said currently over 60% of Sri Lanka's military personnel pursue their young officers courses, junior and senior command courses in India. So also exercise Mitra Shakti, which is the 6th edition of joint military training exercise between Indian Army and Sri Lankan Army, was concluded in Badulla district in Sri Lanka's central province recently. And below you have US designates Iran's elite military unit IRGC. That is Islamic Revolutionary Guard Corps. So this has been designated as a terrorist organization by USA. It says that it promoted tourism. This is the military force of Iran. Then there is no important news here on business page. And on page 16, the business page here too, you have inflows into equity income fund surge. So aided by interest rate cut and other factors, mutual fund sectors are now growing at 17 to 18%, is expected to be the growth in financial year 2020. So this, you can see, a 4-month decline has now been reversed and there has been a marginal increase in overall assets of mutual funds. And this is LNG imports fell 9.1% despite declining prices. So, liquefied natural gas import has fallen for 2019 despite global prices falling, which, you know, shows that there is an established trend in India where LNG imports rise when prices fall. So, this has been a trend, but this has changed now. The import behavior, it is said, could be explained by the dual trends of increased production and decreased consumption within India. So, LNG production in India has increased and its consumption has also decreased. So, that is why imports have fallen. And this is RIL, Reliance Industries Limited, denies links to $1.2 billion money laundering probe. So this is a case related to over-invoicing services and works for pipelines. So these are allegations that the Dutch pipeline company earned $1.2 billion in profit by over invoicing its services and works rendered to Reliance Gas Transport Infrastructure Limited, now known as East West Pipeline Limited. So this is the money laundering case going on. Then there is no news coverage on the last page. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website asr.com in the current affairs section. Here you can download the monthly current affairs PDFs also, and even daily current affairs PDFs are made available here, so they can be downloaded as well. So that is it. Also, detailed current affairs video is a separate course, the details of which are provided here. So that is it. Thank you.